By the end of this video, you should be able to explain why different areas have different climates. You should also be able to explain what is meant by the ITCZ. And on top of this, you should be able to describe the role of ocean currents in the global heat distribution model. Atmospheric cells move air from one location to another in a circular motion. At high pressure belts, the climate is arid or dry. This is because little to no air is rising and cooling, so no precipitation or rain occurs. The dryness of an area means different biomes, and a biome is just a large ecosystem, form there. You may not be surprised to find that the Sahara Desert is located on a high pressure belt. The climate here is arid. So as you can see here, this line illustrates a high pressure band. This is found at 30 degrees north of the equator, and it passes right through this desert. And of course, in a desert, the climate is dry. Atmospheric cells move air from one location to another in a circular motion. At low pressure belts, the climate is wetter. This is because the warm, wet air cools and falls as rain, sleet, or snow. The wetness of an area means different biomes, which again are just large ecosystems, form. You may not be surprised to find that the green areas on this map of Africa here are located in a low pressure belt. The climate here is wet. So here we're looking at Africa, and this line here represents 0 degrees, or the equator. And of course, it's green around the equator because there's plenty of rain. Now, you also need to know about the ITCZ. The ITCZ stands for the Intertropical Convergence Zone, and this is the name given to the central low pressure belt where winds converge as two Hadley cells force air upwards. And on top of this, you need to know about ocean currents. Ocean currents are the large-scale movement of water throughout the world's oceans. The Gulf Stream is an example of an ocean current. Ocean currents maintain climates, particularly near the coast. Places the same distance from the equator can have very different temperatures depending on how near they are to the coast. And we'll call this continentality. This is a measure of how close you are to the sea because of how large the landmass is. By the end of that, you should be able to explain why different areas have different climates. You should also be able to explain what is meant by the ITCZ, and you should be able to describe the role of ocean currents in global heat distribution. Thank you very much for watching. Workbooks and test papers which integrate with these videos and online courses are available at our website, backrowtutoring.com.